Hi guys, welcome back to my channel Blissfully Yum. So we all have had our fair share of indulgence over the past few weeks thanks to the holiday season and the festivities going on. As we welcome a new year with bright new hopes and good health for us and our loved ones, I thought I will end this year on a healthy note with a healthy apple and walnut cake recipe. This cake is eggless, has no butter and is made of whole wheat. And the best part about today's episode is, I am going to show you how to make a cake in a kadai. Buckle up people, we are going to bake a cake but without an oven. Still, if you prefer an oven, at this point preheat the oven to 180 degrees centigrade. And if you are willing to experiment like me, take a deep and heavy bottom cast iron or non-stick kadai. Lay some salt in the bottom of the kadai. The salt helps in uniform distribution of heat within the kadai. Now, place a wire stand or a plate like this on the salt. I got this with my pressure cooker. You can use any steel bowl or plate of your choice. Main motive is to have some space between the bottom of the kadai and our baking tin, so that the batter doesn't come in direct contact with the heat. Now, close the lid and turn on the flame. We are preheating our kadai here. Heat it on low flame for 10 minutes. I have this 7.5-inch aluminium ring mold. You can use any baking tin of your choice that fits your kadai. I'm going to grease the mold with little oil. Coat the whole tin with a light layer of oil. You can instead grease with butter and dust the tin with flour, but keeping it on a healthier side, I prefer to do this. Now for the cake batter, in a food processor or a blender jar, take two peeled and chopped apples. I'm using Granny Smith, you can use any apple. Add the apples to the jar. Then add one ripe banana broken into chunks. If you want exact amount, it is half cup of mashed bananas. Add them with the apples. Then half cup of sunflower oil goes in. You can use any flavorless oil. And 5 tablespoons of honey for sweetness. Ripe bananas are very sweet, so we are using less honey. Now, close the jar and blend it well to a smooth emulsion. Set this aside and let's see the dry ingredients now. In a large bowl, place a sieve. Add to it 1.5 cups of whole wheat flour, 1 teaspoon of baking powder, 3/4 teaspoon of baking soda, 1 teaspoon of ground cinnamon and 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Sift all the dry ingredients well. Mix once again with a spatula. Now add 1/2 cup of chopped walnuts and 1/3 cup of semi-sweet chocolate chips. Coat them well in the flour. This will ensure the walnuts and chocolate chips don't sink down to the bottom of the cake. So that's all. All the ingredients are done for the cake. See, it is so easy to make a healthy and guilt-free cake. Now add the wet mixture to the flour mix and fold it well using a spatula. The mixture will look lumpy as it is whole wheat. The batter won't be smooth, but do not worry, just be careful not to overmix the batter. The cake can turn out tough. So our cake batter is ready. Transfer it to a greased cake tin and distribute evenly using a spatula. For those who are using an oven, bake this in a preheated oven for 40 to 45 minutes. Our kadai has been heated up. We will carefully place our cake tin in our kadai and close the lid. Turn the flame to medium and we will check after 15 minutes. After 15 minutes, our cake has started rising. On medium flame, cook the cake for another 15 minutes. So my glass lid has a hole like this. Close it with a piece of aluminium foil. Now it's around 30 minutes on medium flame. Our cake is still not done yet. When you touch the cake, it sticks, so it needs some more time. I'm going to turn the flame to low and check after another 15 minutes. So after another 15 minutes on low flame, our cake looks done. It no longer sticks and let's check with a skewer. Comes out almost clean. Being a moist cake, it will have light crumbs, but now this cake is ready. So in total, the cake was in the kadai for 30 minutes on medium flame and 15 minutes on low flame. Turn off the flame and take the cake tin carefully out of the kadai. Let the cake cool completely for 30 minutes. Then run a palette knife or butter knife around the edges and in the center too if it is a ring mold. This will help to take out the cake easily. Place a plate on top of the cake tin and invert the cake. Pat gently and lift off the cake tin. So here it is, a beautiful looking and healthy apple and walnut cake. Cut generous slices of the cake and look how soft the cake is. No one will ever believe that it is not baked in an oven. This way, you can make any cake in a kadai. Start 2018 on a healthy note. A very happy new year to all of you. The ingredients and the recipe detail are in the description box below. Make sure you check that out. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit that thumbs up if you like this video. To know more about me and my kitchen stories, follow me on Instagram at SREE'S Blissfully Yum and on Facebook at Blissfully Yum page. I will see you next week. Until then, take care, eat yummy, stay happy. Bye bye.